Victoria Square has become a nightmare for motorists as traffic restrictions surrounding the redevelopment come into place. Joe Hill has been keeping an eye on peak hour traffic. He joins us live from the square with the latest, Joe.
Well, Beck, traffic's flowing fairly smoothly at the moment, but we've already seen today that these changes are going to bring with them a lot of confusion and a lot of frustration for motorists in the city. Now, there's bad news because things are only going to get worse, particularly over the course of the weekend. On top of that, we can expect to see restrictions here in the heart of the city until at least December.
The heart of our city has had its arteries clogged.
It's ridiculous, absolutely ridiculous.
Well, it's already pretty busy and congested up here anyway, so yeah, it's gonna make it harder.
It is a headache, but sometimes you have to work with these things. I'm all for development and improving the city.
It starts with a ban on right-hand turns. Most are already in place, but by tomorrow morning, the final available right-hand turn from King William Street onto Grote Street will be cut off. Grote Street heading east will also drop to one lane, the remaining area left for buses only. Over the weekend, the area around Victoria Square will become a work site, meaning a 25 km an hour speed limit. Adelaide City Council's advice, just avoid the area altogether.
It certainly helps if people can plan ahead and choose alternative routes. The main thing is just be patient, inform yourself of what the restrictions are.
The square's traffic is already groaning with buses substituting for out-of-service train lines. But public transport users shouldn't be impacted. Buses will still be able to turn freely in and around the square. And just to confuse matters further, the restrictions will change over the course of the redevelopment. Council says the inconvenience will pay off once the square's complete.
I'm hoping they're looking beyond where we are now and looking to what it's going to be in the future.
Now, to give you an idea of the headache that King William Street has become, once you hit Angus Street, you can't drive across, you can't access the eastern side of the city until you get all the way down past North Terrace and hit Victoria Drive. So, Beck, council's advice to avoid the area and plan ahead will be very good advice indeed, because it looks like we've got a very long 7 months ahead of us.
Thank you, Joe. Might be time to ride the bike.